Today, let's take a look at calculating percentages in Excel. We're going to take a look at the formula you need to calculate percentage change, and we're going to do it in a way that's going to help you remember it. If you're working as a financial analyst creating reports, this is a formula you need to get right. We're also going to take a look at how we can do calculations that involve percentage increase or decrease. So for example, we have a price. We want to increase price by 15%. What's going to be our end price? Let's get to it. First off, let's take a look at calculating percentage change. Assume your boss gives you an Excel file that contains actual sales data and budget sales. Your task is to calculate percentage change. Let's take this to the board. So you have actual and you have budget. To calculate the difference, you're going to do actual minus budget divided by budget. An alternate way of writing this formula is actual divided by budget minus budget divided by budget, which turns into actual divided by budget minus 1. Now it's all clear, right? So our formula is actual divided by budget minus 1. Double click on the bottom right side and send the formula down. Now let's move on to calculating percentage increase or decrease. Our starting point is in column A. We want to increase the price by the percentage we see in column B, and if it's minus, we want to decrease it. Let's take this to the board. So we have our price. To calculate the price after we add the increase or decrease to it, we're going to add this with price multiplied by that percentage. An alternate way of writing this is to factor out the price. So it's price times 1 plus the percentage, right? So that's another way of writing the formula. So in Excel, this would be starting price multiplied by 1 plus percentage change, close bracket, press enter. So if my starting price was 100, I increase price by 10%, I get 110. If this was 5% instead, I get 105. In Excel, there's one thing you have to be aware of, and that's how you input your percentages. One method to input percentages is to add it while you type. So if I come here and type in 20, followed by the percentage sign and press enter, the cell is automatically formatted as a percentage. Another option is to input it as a decimal. So 0.05 translates to 5%, right? So if I was going to pull this formula down, we can see it adds up correctly as 5%. Now I can change this to a percentage and I get 5%. Now another thing you can do is to format your cell as percentage first before you input your full number. But don't do it the other way around. So for example here, if I was going to input 30 and then I decide, well, this should be a percentage, and I click to format this as a percentage, I get the wrong number, right? So if this was already formatted as a percentage, I go in and input 30, then it works fine. Okay, so let's just pull this one down too. So that's it. Just remember, for a percentage change, it's new divided by old minus 1, or end divided by start minus 1. For percentage increase, we have the formula, your value multiplied by 1 plus the percentage change. And if it's a percentage decrease, is your value times 1 minus the percentage change. But if you input your percentage as negative in Excel, you can use the same formula, just drag it down. So the next time you're asked to calculate the monthly or yearly change, you know how to do it. If you like this video, click that thumbs up. And if you want to improve your Excel skills, consider subscribing to this channel.